Today I am going to share two scary stories of shopping mall, in this episode of the Horror 15 show. So put in your headphones, turn off your lights, and let me take you to a place of dark imagination. Emma and Anne were best friends. Both of them love shopping a lot. It was a sunny day. Emma was wondering to go for shopping. She called Anne and asked her if she could come with her or not. Anne agreed to give company to her best friend. Emma and Anne was in the elevator. Suddenly the power cut off. They don't understand what to do. They thought it was just an accidental power cut. Soon the backup will start. It was about 5 minutes. They were in extreme darkness. Anne could hear some noise. It was like some people were screaming loudly. Emma was afraid and told Anne, "We are trapped." The two girls started screaming for help. They were in the middle of two floors. As a result, no one could hear them. Anne wanted to call for help, but there was no network. The panic grew up. They became more horrified. After 10 minutes, there was silence everywhere. It was like an ocean of silence. Emma started to feel hot in her back. She told, "It is getting hotter." They both stood up. Accidentally, Emma touched the wall of the escalator and her hand was burned. Now they could realize that there was a fire in the mall and they are trapped. They started to scream. The temperature of the box was increasing rapidly. They were in the middle of a fire. The fire burned and peeled away the epidermis, the thin outer layer of skin. After a while, the thicker layer of skin, the dermis, shrinks and splits open, and fat begins to leak out. Skin was burning. Anne's sneakers started to melt. After 20 minutes the rescue team was airbed. On the other side the two girls were melting in the heat of the fire. Skin was burned and the fat was dropping from the body. Emma's eyes were popped out of her skull. The girls could see their own body melting slowly. After 2 hours the fire was under control. Finally the rescue team found two girls in the escalator. It was just burned human flesh. Later the body of the girls was identified by DNA testing. A few years ago, I lived in a large city. It was a bad area with a lot of crime, attracted many crime reporters. I was planning to move out soon. One night I was going home from a hard day at work. I was crossing the city mall. I heard some noise inside the mall. I stopped my car and rushed to the spot. I entered the mall. The elevator was still running. I got into the elevator and pressed the button at third floor. When the doors opened, there was a man standing there. He was dressed in a long overcoat and his hat was pulled down low over his eyes. The man doesn't look like a security man. "Hello," I said, trying to be polite. The man didn't answer. As I got out of the elevator, he passed past me roughly and got into the elevator and started pressing the buttons. "What a jerk," I muttered to myself. I stand up and noticed something strange. There was a dark red stain on the sleeve of my shirt. It looked like blood. It made me feel sick. I didn't know where the blood had come from, but I had my suspicions. I immediately leave the mall and call for emergency. The whole mall was searched, nothing could found, and the watchman don't know how the elevator was still working at the night. We checked the CCTV but no trace of the man was found on the footage. A sketch of the man was made. One the next day I had a date with an attractive young woman I had met. I was getting ready to leave when I heard my doorbell ring. "Who could that be?" I muttered in irritation. I was already late for my date and I didn't want to waste more time. Peering through the peephole, I saw a policeman standing outside. "What is it?" I asked loudly, through the door. I'm sorry to disturb you, sir, he said politely. I wanted to ask you some questions. There was a murder last night in the apartment next door to yours. I was late for my date. I didn't want to get involved. Sorry, officer, I didn't see anything, I said. But you may be able to help us, said the policeman. Did you see anybody suspicious? Can you at least open the door to talk? I wasn't at home last night, I said again. Sorry, officer, I can't help you. All right, sir, the policeman responded. Thank you for your time. He walked off down the hallway and I continued getting ready for my date. For the next few days, I felt very nervous. My next door neighbor had been murdered. The neighborhood was really unsafe. I was glad I was moving out soon. One morning, before going to work, I was wondering if the police had managed to solve the case. I turned on the TV and watched the news, but they didn't mention anything about the murder. When I was leaving for work, I noticed a bad smell in the hallway. It seemed to be coming from the apartment next door to mine. I had a sinking feeling in the pit of my stomach. The hair on the back of my neck stood on end. I went to find the building manager and told him about the smell. When I mentioned the murder, he said there hadn't been any murder in this building. I convinced him to come back up to my floor. When he smelled a stench, he used his master key to open my neighbor's apartment. Both of us were horrified by what we found. The man that I meet in the mall was on the floor, surrounded by a pool of blood. The smell was overpowering. He had been lying there for days. Thanks for watching, and, as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If you have any horror story you want to share, you can share it with us. See you next time.